running Taiwan are trying to be independent of the mainland. That's for sure. And in their efforts to maintain self-government, they've decided to do something that is not that easy. They want to unplug all of the nuclear power that they have, which is, you know, how am I doing? Is it 5 gigawatts? How much is it? All of it, if you had it all plugged in. 5 something?
5.8.
Yeah, okay. Not all of it works. Not all of it's working. All right, but it, you know, it's more than a passing amount. And they've set a goal. Why do they do that? Well, mostly because people went out on the streets and said, you know, this island shakes a lot. And if you've been to Taiwan, it does that. If you're there for a week, chances are you won't be able to have a first-hand experience with this. And they kind of have this example. It's called Japan. And they said, no, we love the Japanese, but not that much. Let's just say no. Okay, now, why does this matter? What is Japan struggling with? Oh, they have a new energy plan. I wonder how well that'll work. Can anyone tell me how well they track their energy plans when it comes to nuclear? Since Fukushima. Oh, it's very, 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 absolutely consistent. They aim here, they come in here. And like India, they become the nuclear India, East Asia. That's an embarrassment. Sorry. What about South Korea? Well, the president there, listening to Jesuits. They're all anti-nuclear. So he's a little squishy, but no more construction beyond the two that are under construction. Of course, he may get voted out in 5 years, 4 years, and a new crew come in, they'll try to spin it up. But, you know, what happens in the next 4 years, of course? And then there's the jewel in the crown, mainland China. How nuclear are they going to be? Well, why do we care? South Korea, Japan can't possibly get nuclear weapons unless they want to. And they can't possibly do it if they want to unless they exploit their civilian nuclear infrastructure. The more of these things you have, the more you come to the conclusion that a little bit of enrichment and reprocessing makes a lot of sense, even if economically it makes no sense at all. Mainland China has all the tritium it wants, all of the highly enriched uranium it wants. It does not have all of the plutonium it might want if it wanted to have a stockpile to rival Russia or the United States. But it could change that. So the size of the legitimate, peaceful parts of these countries can allow them to get into things that are more dangerous. Also, you know, we're right now trying to denuclearize North Korea. We have ringside seats for this show. Not sure how it'll come out, but we've got the Netflix series. We were just told by Mr. Pompeo there's no timeline. It could take at least 3 more years. Pretty honest, huh? How does that story end? If, let's say Japan wants to reprocess and it assumes it's going to have a large number of reactors on. Simple point. If nuclear power in Taiwan can can be closed out without trauma, it's going to have knock-on effects. And I, for one, do not necessarily think those are going to be knock-on effects that are going to be negative to the security picture. I'm not arguing that you unplug nuclear power. I'm not arguing that it's going to go away right away. But I'm not sure you want to see them fail when people reach the conclusion, oh, we need to redouble government expenditures in this sector. So what happens there in Taiwan is kind of the canary in the nuclear cave in this region. They don't see it that way. No need for them to, but there's plenty of reason for us to see that. So, passing interest, is it even likely that they can meet this ambitious goal? I'm skeptical. But tonight, we're going to see what the experts have. We have someone who is from Taiwan, who is an energy expert. We have somebody who's from the United States that goes to Taiwan and is actively working to make, am I right, suggestions, if not sales. Conflict of interest, so he's interesting. And then, my favorite is we have an expert who's never been to Taiwan. And is an Asian expert.
Yes.
Yes. More on that later. So, between these three perspectives, I think we'll be able to get a beginning picture. One final advertisement. The reason I funded this work wasn't simply for the reasons I stated. Sorry. Can you beat this? Okay. It's because we have a project center to examine what the nuclear futures of several developing states, Saudi Arabia, Iran, mainland China, Taiwan might be, as part of a dry run effort to implement the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Act's Title V, which has never, ever been done because Congress in its wisdom and courage legislated the requirement that we look at what these developing countries might need, whether they could meet their energy and environmental requirements without nuclear power or less of it, and decided it really didn't want to get the report. So it's been sitting for 40 years. It's one law that's never been followed. So I thought, maybe I can report to you.
Yes.
Okay. The paper first. Alexa, you're on deck.